So let's start today's session, that is your cell reference. So basically we have a five types of a cell reference, that is relative cell reference, absolute cell reference, mixed cell reference, circular cell reference, and then 3D cell reference. Okay, out of that, today we are going to start with the first option called as relative cell reference. So basically what does it mean? Like, relative means your adjacent cell has a value and that are dragged together. By default, Excel provides you relative cell reference only. I repeat, by default, Excel provides you relative cell reference. Let me explain with the examples. I have an example, salesman name, Jan, Feb, March, and then finally we want the total. For example, I have a data on each and every month, that is Jan, Feb, and March. So when I used to click equal to sum, when I select it from here to here, correct now, when I close bracket and enter button, so I am getting it and additional data. Yes. Because these datas are relevant data. So how you can check it, your data is relevant or no? When I click on this, so automatically you can see this blue line, because these lines indicates we have a relative cell reference. So that is known as a, by default your cells are always relative cell reference. Okay. Let me explain with the reference. Okay. Let me explain with the second, known as your absolute cell reference. Okay. To understand with the absolute cell reference, here you can see I have a quantity rate and then finally 18% of GST. When I click on this equal to quantity into rate, so I got the, but I wanted 18% of GST also. I don't want total, I want 18% of GST amount. For getting a GST amount, I need to multiply this. Correct now, to add this or edit into this cell, you have to press F2 sign or simply go back to this year and then into what 18%. See, I never use any kind of a reference. That means by default this become a relative cell reference. I repeat, by default this become as a relative cell reference. Now this answer is correct. When I drag it, you can see the answer. Now this is a problem. Why this is problem? Let me explain with the examples. When I click to this, you can see this cell is getting multiplied with the quantity multiply rate into GST. Yes. This is correct. Whenever we go down, and now we can see what is getting multiplied with what? Quantity is getting multiplied with the rate, and then this is getting multiplied with
percent. Yes.
Or simply what I can do it, I can drag it and place it like this. Now when I hit enter button, I am getting the answer. Yes. But is it you are going to do it every time? No, there must be some like way where we can drag it and get the answer of each and every one. So that can be eliminated by using your absolute cell reference. Absolute cell reference. Let me introduce equal to quantity multiply rate. I repeat, this is a quantity multiply rate into 18%. But this 18% has to be fixed. For this fixing, we have a cell and row and column. So we have a three options. Now in this situation, we want to fix up the cell. Hame cell ko fix karni hai. Kisko?
Cell
ko. So I just press F4 sign once. I repeat, I just press F4 sign once. Whenever you are pressing F4 sign once, that is known as cell reference. Now you can drag it and you will get the result of each and every one. This is due to absolute cell reference. Clear now?
Yes, sir.
So here what we use? We use F4, but how many time? One time. Correct now?
Yes, sir.
Because we use the cell reference. That is absolute cell reference. Okay. Now, we'll go back to the next option, that is mixed cell reference. This is another data. Correct? In this data, you will see your record is basic salaries also keep on changing. As well as the percentage of this is also keep on changing. That is HRA, correct now, criteria is also keep on changing. So what I can do it, if I'll go to this equal to, I multiply basic with this amount, 25%. I got the answer. Is it? This is the correct answer. But when I drag it, is it I am getting a correct answer?
No.
Why I am not getting a correct answer? To understand what mistakes I did. Whenever I am clicking over here, I can see this blue is getting multiplied with this red one.
Yeah.
When we click down and see the same scenario, what is getting multiplied with what? See, this cell is keep on changing. This is correct.
Yes, sir.
But what happened to this? This what happened to this? This should not be changed.
Change, yeah.
This has to be fixed. Correct now.
Yes,
to resolve these problems, I just click to this and again I press the F4 sign once. So I got the answer is correct. Mm-hmm. Then drag it down. You will get the rest options.
Yes.
But unfortunately, if you are dragging it like this horizontally, this answer cannot be correct. Do you think 5000 multiply 25% will be this, and when the 5000 multiply 30% this is decrease? This has to be increased. So that means there must be some error. What mistakes we did? Chalo, let us find it out. In this scenario, again 1 to 5 zeros getting multiplied with 25%, but it should get multiplied with what? 30%. But now it is getting, so that means the reference has to be changed from there to here. I repeat, reference has to change from there to here. Correct now?
Yes.
Again, when we go back to the next scenario, when I click to this, see this what happened? 30. This is getting multiplied with this. This is getting multiplied with this. When this is totally wrong. This 5000 has to be multiplied. Now it is getting this amount to be multiplied. That means this reference is wrong. Are you getting it, my point? That this data basic is keep on changing in a columnar tab. It is changing like the column wise data. How your data is flowing? Column wise. So what is the name of your column in this scenario? L. So I just click over here and I just put the dollar sign before the L. That is known as column absolute. That is known as column absolute. Same thing can be done by pressing F4 three times. 1, 2, 3. I repeat, same thing can be done with the, so that means this cell is keep on changing column wise. Let me multiply with this. But how this cell is keep on changing like this way? Horizontal. Correct. So this is keep on changing row wise. So what is row? Row is your 3. Correct. So I just put a dollar sign before the 3. Or otherwise, I can replace by pressing F4 sign 1, 2. Correct. Now this is row and column both are changing. Now if you drag, you will get your answer as it is. Now just have a glance at a look like how your formula works. Like 2000, 20,000 is getting multiplied with what?
35%.
And I got this answer. And same thing we are expecting also.
Yes.
When I click to this, then what should happen? This 10,000 is getting multiplied with 30. Let me see this and check it out. Yes, sir. Now it is working correctly. Now it is working correctly. This is only because of the reason I use the cell reference. When your data flow, I repeat, when your data flow is in column wise, then press F4 how many times?
Three times.
This is the correct answer. When your data flows in the row, then press F4 times how many times? Two times. Correct?
Yes, sir.
When your data is in the cell, then press F4 how many times? One time. Correct?
Mm-hmm.
So these will be three reference: column, row and cell. And Excel sheet is consist of row, column and cell only. Nothing else. I repeat, nothing else.
Yes.
I hope clear this is?
Yes.
Okay. Now we did the third part that we known as mixed cell reference. So we did first called as relative cell reference, then the absolute cell reference, and then what?
Mixed cell reference.
I hope clear with this?
Yes.
We'll go to the third option, fourth option, that is circular cell reference. That is so known as, for example, if I'll tell you, just tell me the profit. Can you guess it? Revenue means what? Revenue means what? This is my income. But to obtain this income, I have a expenses called as 1,15,000. So what will be the my profit? See the simple language, my profit will be revenue minus this. But does it consist of bonus? Does it amount consist of bonus also? No, sir.
No, sir.
There is no involvement of a bonus. For example, I just put a bonus as a 5,000. Then what should be my profit? Tell me.
80,000.
That profit tell me?
80,000.
That means simply you are saying this amount minus this amount minus this plus this. Yes or no?
Yes.
So I am getting a profit of 80,000. how it is getting calculated, is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, let me tell you once again. See, this now, okay, equal to this 2 lakhs minus all expenses. See, this cost is my expenses. For example, this is a salary of employee. So that has to be minus. Plus, I am giving a bonus to my employee. So that is also expenses for me. So that also has to be subtracted from this. So that means I have a total profit of 80,000. For example, management says, if this bonus is not there, then my profit will be 80,000. But the 85,000 is also have a consideration of this also. इसका मतलब ये हुआ कि आप प्रॉफिट कैलकुलेट करने के लिए आपने रेवेन्यू रेवेन्यू कॉस्ट एंड बोनस तीनों का यूज किया. हाँ, बोनस आपका जीरो है, सो दैट इज व्हाट इट गिव्स यू द जीरो अमाउंट. दैट मींस आई एम गेटिंग 85,000. इफ इट इज अ 5,000, देन आई एम गेटिंग अमाउंट एज 80,000. आई होप डिफरेंस समझ में आ गया. सपोज मैनेजमेंट कहता है कि सर अगर हमें प्रॉफिट हो रहा है प्रॉफिट हो रहा है, तो उस प्रॉफिट का 10% हम लोग शेयर कर देते हैं एज ए बोनस. भाई हमारा मैनेजमेंट थोड़ा सा दिलदार है, उसने ये सोचा अगर प्रॉफिट हो रहा है तो लेट वर्कर ऑल्सो टू बी एंजॉय दिस फैसिलिटी. करेक्ट. ओके, सो क्या करना चाहिए गाइस? इसका मतलब प्रॉफिट का हमें 10% कैलकुलेट करना होगा एज ए बोनस. तो व्हाट आई एम डूइंग इट इक्वल टू दिस 85,000 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 10%. नाउ व्हेन आई हिट द एंटर बटन, दैट इज योर ट्रेजेडी स्टार्ट. जैसे ही मैंने एंटर बटन प्रेस कर दिया, नाउ कंप्यूटर सेज सर्कुलर सेल रेफरेंस. व्हाट डज इट मीन? द सर्कुलर सेल रेफरेंस सेज फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग अ प्रॉफिट यू हैव ऑलरेडी यूज्ड द ऑप्शन कॉल्ड एज बोनस. नाउ फॉर गेटिंग अ बोनस यू आर यूजिंग अ ऑप्शन कॉल्ड एज प्रॉफिट. इसका मतलब प्रॉफिट निकालने के लिए हम बोनस यूज कर रहे हैं और बोनस निकालने के लिए प्रॉफिट. तो बोथ आर इंटरनली कनेक्टेड टू ईच अदर. सो नाउ कंप्यूटर इज नॉट रेडी टू कैलकुलेट सच काइंड ऑफ आंसर्स. तो कंप्यूटर में इस तरह के आंसर कैलकुलेट नहीं करते. गाइस अब हमें क्या करना चाहिए? करेक्ट. एनी गेसेस? कुछ सोच सकते हैं आप? जी हाँ, मैं जानता हूँ छोटा ब्रेन है, इसके लिए आप ज्यादा नहीं सोचेंगे, लेकिन सोचना चाहिए कि अगर ये कैलकुलेशन नहीं हो रहा है तो व्हाट वी कैन डू इट. वी विल गो बैक टू द फाइल. आई रिपीट, वील गो बैक टू द फाइल. देन वी हैव अ ऑप्शन. इन दैट ऑप्शन वी हैव अ फॉर्मूला. इन दैट फॉर्मूला आई एम गोइंग टू क्लिक ऑन दिस ऑप्शन कॉल्ड इटरेटिव कैलकुलेशन. व्हाट डिड आई सेड? इनेबल इटरेटिव कैलकुलेशन. दैट मीन्स do internally dependent calculation also. When I click on OK, see, now I am getting exactly as 77272, and the 10% of 7727 is 77727. I hope this is cleared.
Yes.
So like this kind of a circular cell reference can get the result by using file, then option, and then formula, and then click to what? Enable iterative. So it works only when you have interdependent. It works when we have interdependent. So we did the four types of a reference. Now we are moving back to the last option, that is 3D cell reference. Okay, for that I have a data called as Jan, Feb and March. I repeat, I have a data on Jan. Okay. To obtain with the 3D cell reference, there is one limitation also that I will ask to you. I'll tell you the advantage, you have to tell me the disadvantage. That is limitation you have to tell me, or otherwise write the disadvantage on the comments. Correct. Now write your disadvantage on the comments. Okay, let me start for on the comments. Okay, let me start. For example, my management says, sir, give me the total commission of Jan, Feb, March. एज अ ले मैन वॉट यू विल डू इट, सिंपली हर एक बंदा क्या करता है, इक्वल टू सर हम सम करेंगे, इजेंट एड, ये रहा सर हमने सम कर लिया है, इक्वल टू सम एंड देन डू द सिलेक्शन एंटर. गाइज इज इट क्लियर? इक्वल टू सम देन अगेन डू द सिलेक्शन एंटर. करेक्ट. नाउ लेट मी कम बैक टू द फर्स्ट शीट. करेक्ट, दिस इज माई फर्स्ट शीट. वॉट विल डू इट इक्वल टू सर हम जन में जाएंगे दिस प्लस, फैब में जाएंगे प्लस, देन मार्च में जाएंगे प्लस, एंड देन एंटर बटन. करेक्ट. बट आपको कुछ अलग तरीके से करना है सर, हम ऐसे नहीं करेंगे. This is one way to get the results. In Excel, there are many ways to obtain your results. One way to get the results. In Excel, there are many ways to obtain your results. It is not necessary there are one way. See, when you are an expert, so you can have a same option by using n number of methods. So let me introduce the next method called as 3D cell reference. I repeat, 3D cell reference. Okay. We will not use these things. Let me, but we don't want that. Correct na? Is it clear? Okay. So let me begin. Please pay attention. Equal to sum. Then I click to this option and I selected from year to year. I hope this is clear.
Yes, sir.
Even though this is also one kind of a cell reference. Huh? This is also one kind of a cell reference. Correct. I just selected from here to here. Any doubts? After that, you have to hold the shift button. Hold the
shift button.
Okay. And click end of the sheet. Because I want the total and that total should be clubbed off Jan, Feb and March. I guess clear?
Yes, sir.
Then finally close the bracket and press enter button. This is a last option. My job is done. Which one is best?
This one.
So okay, let me revise it once again. Clear now? Okay. How to start? Tell me. I just click to this equal to sum. Selection of these three. Hold the shift button. Then click on last cell. Okay. Close it and press enter. Correct now?
Yes.
Okay. So now what we have learned today? Relative cell reference, absolute cell reference, mixed cell reference, circular cell reference and
3D cell.
3D cell reference, circular cell reference and
3D cell.
3D cell reference. Clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And the cell references can be done by using a shortcut key. That is, if you have a data in column, then F4. Three times. If you have a row, then F4.
Two times.
If you have a cell, then F4. One time. Guys, clear?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. Write the drawbacks of 3D cell reference. I have just explained you the advantage. You have to tell me the disadvantage. Correct now? Clear? You have to tell me the disadvantage. For you to do the practice, I am providing you one more Excel sheet. I repeat, I am providing you one more Excel sheet where you have to sit and do your practice. See, I have a first sheet called as relative, then second one absolute, then third one is mixed, and then the fourth option is your circular, and then finally we have a 3D sheet. Correct now?
Yes.
Then east, west, north and south. So this sheet I am providing you, you have to download it and do your practice. Clear? If you have any queries, then you can send me your queries also. So let me end the today's sessions. Till then, have a great day. So let's